Slag knew we were coming, and she knew her time was up. But she was determined to have the last laugh. Columns of smoke on the horizon were the first sign of what she'd been planning. At nightfall, the distant hills were glowing red with the spreading fire. Scorched earth tactics. She was burning the mines, destroying the resources we were after. Our slag may be defeated soon, but she would make sure our victory would have been for nothing. Our alliance with Grimheim would likely return to ashes as well. We had to stop her without delay. So it looks like your hometown of Tor Lindhath has become the heart of our struggle against Auslag's warbands, Lady Vilma.
The dwarves here are used to trading with the Holy Empire. They understand the importance of maintaining the peace.
As a matter of fact, much of the stained glass in my own throne room was made here.
slip.
Auslag and her warbands were on a rampage. Everywhere fires were being started. We had to move faster, or all of this would have been for naught.
Black.
Oh! Yeah! Yeah. This is going to get ugly. Auslag is like a rabid wolf. She won't go down without a fight, and I don't expect her to fight fair. Are you sure you want to be here, Vilma? Shouldn't you be with your son? I know you left him with your husband in Torlindoth, but still.
Don't worry about me. I might not be a shield maiden anymore, but I'm still a warrior of the Winterwind clan. I won't die so easily.
Aye, aye. I know you're a tough lass. Eric is a lucky dwarf. He's already had a son of a previous marriage, right? Are the two boys getting along well?
Ah, they're always bickering. They have very different personalities. But Eric considers both of them to be of his blood. That makes things simpler.
Eric is a good man. Still, if Wulfstan grows up to be half the dwarf you and his actual dad were, Grimheim's future will be in good hands.